So a wrapped token is an ERC-20 token, the price of which represents another asset or an underlying asset. So the simplest example of these are your stable coins, right? Your Tether, USDC, and the like. And it's an interesting concept, mostly from a financial perspective, because if you have a wrapped token that is linked to a futures-backed commodity, let's say gold, for instance, right, and the price of gold, there's an arbitrage in there, because obviously you can buy that token and sell the future, right, sell the futures product. And that would allow you to effectively lock in your gain predicated on the price of gold. The price of gold goes up, you make money on the token. Price of gold goes down, you make money in the future, right? So it's an interesting concept, but it implicates a lot of legal issues because of potential for redemption. And I've kind of touched upon this before with respect to, let's say, the easiest, the low-hanging fruit, stable coins. In order for you to offer a redemption function, the issuer or promoter of that token would need to be registered as a money service business, right? And that's why you see Tether not offer the redemption function in the United States, but offer it in Europe, because they're not registered as an MSB, right? And that same can be said for the remaining main stable coins, right? You can't redeem in the United States, you can't redeem that stable token for a dollar, for instance, right? But the same holds true with respect to other assets. So if you wanted to do a wrapped token that was linked to the price of, say, silver, and that token had a redemption function that would enable you to receive a certain amount of silver, that too, even though it's not fiat currency, would actually implicate money service business registration requirements, because you're effectively transferring crypto for value, right? And even though that value isn't in the form of other crypto or currency, fiat currency, MSB registration would still likely be required. Now, the other angle too is that, you know, these wrapped tokens, when they're just tied to the price, there's really nothing to it, right? From a legal standpoint, it's just another cryptocurrency, and you have your share of sort of legal morass that you have to deal with. But and the redemption function actually entertains a whole nother set of legal complexities. But you also have a commodities aspect, right? What this begins to look like is either a swap product or a futures product, in the sense that you can redeem the token for a commodity, right? For a product of some kind. So it takes the appearance of a commodity as defined in the Commodities Act. And so as an exchange, if you're going to list these wrapped tokens that offer this redemption function, you have to be very careful and not be the unwary, right? In the sense that you're listing what is ostensibly a futures product and you're not a commodities exchange, and so, which requires a whole set of regulations and registrations, which I can talk about at a later time. But it's really something to consider, right? And these wrapped tokens, I think the redemption function always fails, right? Like, I look at it, the redemption function, it never works. Like it backed by gold, backed by silver, backed by oil, backed by, you know, dirt in the ground, it never really works, right? Because the sort of extrapolation of token and value, the underlying asset, you can never keep up with, right? And so you see a lot of stuff, and there's two coming out of Australia that are allegedly backed by gold, but we can't back our own dollar by gold. So what makes you think you can back your cryptocurrency by gold? It's just sort of fallacious reasoning, right? But irrespective of the fact, I think wrapped tokens have a great place if you know how to use them in the trading game for hedging, right? It's a phenomenal product if there's volume, of course, if there's volume in the token for hedging, if it's especially hedged against a futures product, right? But from a legal perspective, if you're going into that redemption function, like you've seen with stable coins, it just implicates too many rules that makes the efficacy of that token ineffective, right? It kind of destroys that efficacy. So think about it. It's great in concept, poor in practice, at least at this time. And obviously, as with everything I say, it's subject to change on a day-to-day basis based on rules and regulations that change on a day-to-day basis. So check me out, Adam Tracy, TRACY.io. Happy to answer any questions you have, and I'll talk to you soon.